Would you know what to do in a nightmare situation like this? Fans everywhere are wondering just that in the wake of the terrifying panic outside the Washington Nationals ballpark. Security expert Bill Stanton is giving me some important advice.
Wherever you go, know where your exits are. Do a quick walk around. It'll take you a couple of minutes to walk the circumference. Just scope things out. So there's an exit there. There's an exit in back of you.
But if you can't make it to an exit,
we see some people cowering under seats. We see some people running in the other direction. What's the right thing to do?
Well, I like some people that actually jumped in the dugout because rules go out the window. I hear shots and I see people running away. If I'm getting a beer or a pretzel, I'm going right over that counter, underneath the counter, and I'm riding it out.
We're learning more about the gunfire that erupted outside Nationals Park on Saturday night. Thousands poured out of the stadium. Others ducked for cover as they hurried to the exits. There was a mad scramble in a restaurant. Parents scrambled to protect their children.
I just kind of laid on the ground, on the concrete there.
Stanley Cordova's son, Ben, shot this video as they huddled low.
Hey, come down, come down, come down.
So how scary was this whole situation?
I guess it was scary because of the people running around kind of in that panic mode.
CBS News correspondent Chris Van Cleve was at the game and shot this video.
This was the view from my seat as the crowd ducked for cover.
Cops say the gunfire was exchanged between two cars just outside the stadium. They're looking for this Toyota Corolla with a missing hubcap. The stadium shooting capped a weekend of violence that outraged citizens in the nation's capital after a six-year-old Naya Courtney was killed in a drive-by shooting.
This is a six-year-old who is now dead, not coming back.
In Chicago, 56 people were shot over the weekend, 11 of them killed.
Jen Psaki.
On Sunday, calm returned to Nationals Park. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki threw out the first pitch, a scene of serenity so unlike the previous day's terror.